morning, IBFB kids. This is Hermana Patty.
Hi, this is Hermana Silvia. Welcome back.
Welcome back. And today we have our continuation of the fruit of the Spirit. Today we will be talking about gentleness.
Yeah, so.
Which is another word for kindness.
Kindness, that's correct. So we have some new characters that will be coming in today, and we're super excited. I think you're really going to enjoy this lesson. Mm-hmm. But let's go ahead and get started with a couple of songs, and let's bow our heads and let's close our eyes as we pray, okay? Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for this day. Thank you for being oh so good to us. And I pray that you bless today's lesson. I pray that you bless the songs and help the children to enjoy it. In your name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
I am a C-H-R-I-S-T-I-A-N, and I have C-H-R-I-S-T in my A-T-A-R-T, and I will L-I-V-E-E-T-E-R-N-A-L-L-Y. I am a C-H-R-I-S-T-I-A-N, and I have C-H-R-I-S-T in my A-T-A-R-T, and I will L-I-V-E-E-T-E-R-N-A-L-L-Y. Walking with Jesus, walking every day, walking all the way, walking with Jesus, walking with Jesus today, walking in the sunshine, walking in the rain, walking every day, walking all the way, walking in the sunshine, walking in the rain, walking with Jesus today. Walking with Jesus, praying every day, praying all the way, praying with Jesus, praying with Jesus today. Praying in the sunshine, praying in the rain, praying
today. Hi, I'm Robbie. Today, me and my friend Jose have a very special Fruit of the Spirit play in one act that we are going to do for you.
Yeah, it's called the Good Planetarium.
That's the Good Samaritan, Jose.
Oh yeah, that's what I meant.
The Good Samaritan is a famous story that Jesus told to the people a long time ago. He told us so people would know that God wants us to be kind to others.
So what are we waiting for, Rob? Let's learn about the next fruit of the Spirit, gentleness, which also means kindness.
Okay.
Oh. Have a nice trip. Ha 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 ha.
Oh my goodness. Look at this. There's a guy laying in a pile. He looks like he might be hurt. Well, I'm in such a hurry. I'm sure someone else will help him. I'll remember to pray for him, though. I'll just sneak away before he notices me.
Uh-oh, what do we have here? I suppose I should see if he needs any help. Yoo-hoo, young man, do you need my help? He didn't say anything. He must be okay. I'd better be getting along now. Bye.
Oh.
Whoa! Hey there! This is no place to be taking a nap. Oh, geez. You're not napping, are you? Are you, like, beat up? Did some guy clunk you over the head or something?
Oh.
I'll take that as a yes. Well, never fear, because I, the good librarian, am here to help you.
Samaritan. Jose, good Samaritan, not good librarian.
Chill, Rob. You're supposed to be, like, knocked out.
Get it right.
Okay, okay. I, the good origami, will help you.
Oh, I give up. Let's get on with the story. Wait, camera, will you please cut that, please? Oh.
First, I will take you to a doctor so he can fix your injury. Then, I will get you a nice, comfortable room to stay in. There's a nice Hilton just up the road, and I'll stick with you until you're all better and buy you anything you need to get back on your own two feet.
But you don't even know me.
It doesn't matter. Jesus said that we should love our neighbor as we love ourselves. When he was talking to your neighbor, he meant all other people around you. He meant pretty much everybody. That includes you, my downtrodden friend.
Thanks. I will never forget your kindness, good Samaritan.
Don't mention it. It's just another day's work for the good aquarium.
Thank you for watching our little play, The Good Samaritan. If you want to read the real story of the Good Samaritan that Jesus told, you can read it in Luke 10:25. The Good Samaritan showed kindness, gentleness, and love to the traveler who had been robbed. Bye for now.
Hey, boys and girls. Thank you so much for watching this play right here. The guys did an amazing job of enacting the story of the Good Samaritan. And I just want to thank you guys as well for taking the time to watch this video, guys. Remember, if it wasn't for you guys being here watching us, we wouldn't be able to make these videos. And so we thank you so much, guys, for watching this video. I want to mention a little bit about this story that we just saw right now about the Good Samaritan. And so God mentions this in the Bible in the book of Luke chapter 10. And so he gives us this story so that we can also see how God wants us to be in our own lives. Now, he mentions one of the fruits of the Spirit that we're talking about this week is gentleness. It also means to be kind or kindness. So if we can just think about all the things that we love, and we can mention our mom and dad, we can mention our family, our friends, our school teachers, we can mention a lot of people that we love. And there are so many ways that we can show people that we love them. But one of the ways that we can do that is by being kind to them. Now, just as in the story, there was a good Samaritan that was kind to a stranger and helping them in need. God gives us a story to help us remember that we can also be kind to others that are also in need as well. So I'm going to read one verse, guys, and it's in Luke chapter 10 and verse number 37. Jesus is talking here. He says, "He that showed mercy on him, then said Jesus unto him, go and do thou likewise." And so Jesus is basically saying he gave the story of the Good Samaritan. When the Good Samaritan decided to help the stranger, he said he wants us to do likewise. Now, I want to challenge you all, guys, to do one thing this week. I want you to think about somebody you love, whether it's your mom and dad, your brothers and sisters, your friends from school, your school teachers, your pastor's wife, anybody you can think of. And I want you to show kindness to them, whether that's writing them a letter saying, "I love you and I'm praying for you," or whether it's telling your mom and dad, "I'm going to keep my room clean this week." Whatever comes to your mind, show kindness, just like the way the Good Samaritan did in this story, guys. Remember, God says one of the fruits of the Spirit is gentleness, that we are to be kind to one another. And if you can, be kind to somebody new, whether that's at the store or anywhere, guys, okay? So remember, guys, I challenge you guys to be kind to someone, show them the kindness that Jesus wants you and I to show to this world. All right, guys, thank you so much for watching this video. Keep in mind, we got more coming up in the next weeks to come, so keep on watching. All right, guys, y'all take care.
Okay, so which fruit of the Spirit did we talk about today?
Gentleness.
Which is another word for kindness. Okay, Ruthie, which fruit of the Spirit did we talk about last week?
Long-suffering.
Okay, which is another word for patience. Go ahead.
All right, children, we hope you really enjoyed the lesson and the new characters that were here today. And we know we really enjoyed having Brother Xavier. So let's remember that challenge that he gave us. Miss Patty?
Kindness. So let's practice that during the week or, you know, every day.
Every day while at school or with your family. And we would love to hear from you. If you have something you want to share, like Miss Silvia, Miss Patty, this is what happened this week. Mm-hmm. We would love to hear from you. So let's go ahead and end in a word of prayer. All right. Miss Patty, you want to lead us in a word of prayer?
Thank you, Lord, for this day that you've given us. Thank you for your many blessings, Lord. We ask you, Lord, to help us throughout the week. Help us to practice kindness to everyone around us, Lord. Thank you for everything you do for us. In your name, Jesus, we ask you this. Amen.
All right, we'll see you next week. Bye.
Bye. Thank you.